He spent the last 18 days behind bars and today has been granted bail. Joining us now, Sanjeev Bhatt. Mr. Bhatt, thank you for speaking with Times. Now, no doubt relief, but is this only phase one in the battle? Are we going to see this duel on both sides get more heated?
Tamanna, this was always going to be a long-drawn battle. The fight for justice has never been easy anywhere in the world. So this is going to be long-drawn and I'm prepared for much worse. And so should they be.
Do you believe much worse will come your way?
It could, Tamanna. See, because they are desperate people. This is a desperate government headed by a very desperate man. So they will resort to desperate measures. So I won't be surprised with anything.
Well, a lot of people also question, Mr. Bhatt, that if they are going to take your allegations at face value and investigate them, then why not do the same for the allegations by Mr. K.D. Pant leveled against you? Would you say that's a fair premise?
Absolutely. And that is exactly what my prayer is before the Supreme Court, that the FIR filed by Pant, which according to me was done at the behest of the Chief Minister, Narendra Modi, that FIR needs to be investigated by an agency which is not under the control of the state government of Gujarat. So if that is done, that will bring out the complete and the whole truth as to how the FIR came into being, as to what are the forces which work behind all these people, as to how they are trying to influence witnesses, as to how they want to destroy evidence, everything will come out. That is exactly what my prayer is in writ petition criminal 135, which is pending before the Supreme Court right now.
Do you believe that you are being targeted by the Gujarat state government?
I won't call it being targeted. They are doing their bit, Tamanna. I am doing what is required of me by the law. They are doing what is required of them to protect themselves. So I would not say they are targeting me. They are trying to protect themselves. Every criminal has a right to protect himself. Narendra Modi has a right to try and protect himself, so let him do it.
But do you think that in this battle, as you've pitched yourself against the chief minister of a state who enjoys popularity within his state, do you find yourself in a corner all alone? Do you think you have enough really to move in your battle forward?
Tamanna, I don't find myself alone at all. But that's immaterial. Even if I was alone, I would not have cared. Because for me, Narendra Modi is a common criminal who happens to be the chief minister, but that doesn't make any difference. As a police officer, I see him as a criminal, and I will continue to see him as a criminal. And I'll do all that is required of me by the law of this country. So if I have to go it alone, I'll go it alone. But fortunately, I have the support of so many other right-thinking people, friends, officers, media, everyone.
That's fine, but as far as it comes down to investigation, the cases currently against you and some of the charges you've made are being investigated by the Gujarat state or authorities under the Gujarat state. Do you think that that is satisfactory? Mm-hmm. In a response, the Home Ministry said they will also be investigating the charges against you leveled by K.D. Pant. Do you think that is something you'd have more faith in?
As I said, Tamanna, we have requested the Supreme Court to transfer the investigation of K.D. Pant's FIR to an agency outside the control of Gujarat. So once that happens, the entire picture will become clear before the people of this country as to how the systems are being subverted in Gujarat, as to how justice is miscarried in Gujarat. So that is exactly my prayer before the Supreme Court.
What do you see happening next? Because you obviously are preparing yourself as well. You're saying worse will come your way or worse could come your way after K.D. Pant. What do you see happening next?
See, it could be anything. This government can even try to eliminate me. They have done this earlier with Harin Pandya. They can resort to anything. So I'm prepared for anything at all. When I say anything, I mean anything. So I will keep on doing my job and they will keep on doing what they do best.
Are you making a charge that there is a threat to your life from the Narendra Modi government?
I am a threat to Narendra Modi and his stooges and his cohorts. So they will try to neutralize that threat. And if they have to eliminate me, they won't mind doing that. If they find the right kind of people to do it, probably they will not find the right kind of people to do it given the situation in Gujarat. But they will do anything to eliminate a threat like they did in the case of Harin Pandya.
Have you been threatened?
But yeah, that will not deter me at all.
Have you been threatened so far, directly or indirectly?
I don't think there is anyone in Gujarat who would have the guts to threaten me, Tamanna. I can deal with any kind of threat on my own without any state support.
You know, as someone who was who had a very important role in the police machinery during the time of the riots, don't you find it strange that there are not more voices backing you, or there's no one really coming out and saying what you're saying?
I'm surprised you're saying that, Tamanna. All the people who have worked with me during that period, all of them have come out in my support, be it my then bosses, be it my colleagues. Everyone knows the truth in Gujarat. The fact that they may not be able to state it openly at present is different. But all of them, all my earlier bosses have come out in my support, and they have affirmed each and every word of what I have said till now.
Yes, but are you saying they're unwilling to stick their necks out like you have, or are they under some kind of pressure? Because it would seem, and that's how the Narendra Modi government is putting it, that you may have your own vested interest right now.
Narendra Modi government would like people to believe that I am doing this out of vested interest because that suits them. Well, they may continue believing that. I don't need to even dignify their stand by denying it. They are entitled to any belief which they want to harbor. But the fact is that there are criminals in the government who will be brought to book very soon.
You have also claimed that those in the Gujarat government have destroyed evidence which was at your residence about a year ago. Can you elaborate on that charge?
That's right. This is a part of my writ petition before the Supreme Court. Last year, about I think a year ago or maybe about 11 months ago, my mother's house was burgled twice within a space of 4 days. Not only was it burgled, but they set so many documents on fire. They broke open all the cupboards, all the safes. And there was one safe which they could not break. So 3 days after the first burglary, they again broke into the house. They hacked open that safe and burned the documents which were lying there. So they have been trying to do all this.
What is this evidence?
And even this time, even after my arrest, they...
Yes. Now, what is this evidence you're saying that you have that needs to be destroyed as far as the Gujarat government is concerned? What is this evidence?
Tamanna, I was with the Intelligence Bureau in 2002. I was one of the longest serving officers in the Bureau then. And I have documented so much about the Gujarat riots in 2002. And there was so much contemporaneous record which we had created for the consumption of different agencies. So the government is apprehensive that I might be having certain records which they claim that they have destroyed. The government believes that certain records have been destroyed by them, but there might be copies lying around. So that is why they are trying to look for that evidence and destroy it. This is evidence which would be very incriminating for Narendra Modi and his stooges in the government who were involved in the facilitation of the riots. This may be evidence pertaining to the murder of Harin Pandya. This may be evidence pertaining to the ongoing subversion of the criminal justice system in Gujarat. There is so much that is going on. This may be evidence about the snooping that is taking place in Gujarat. In Gujarat, the officers are not even prepared to speak on the cell phones right now because they know every cell phone of every officer is being heard. So that is the kind of subversion that is taking place here. And the government believes I have evidence which can nail them, so they are desperate to get it.
Do you have a message for Narendra Modi right now, Mr. Bhatt?
I have no message for him. I can just thank him for adding purpose to my resolve. So I'm thankful to him and his stooges for having added purpose. And wish him all the best. May his devil help him.